Okay, so welcome to Cooking with Si again. So just to show you what we're doing tonight, basically this is going to be teriyaki salmon. I've got a couple of pieces of salmon there that have been marinated in teriyaki. A couple of peppers, onion and some mushrooms, some rice to serve it with. Just to show you, it's nothing special. This is just sweet teriyaki sauce that you can buy in a shop. It's a bit of a cheap meal, is this, but delicious nonetheless. So I'll get it all prepped and we'll come back. Right, so I've just got a little bit of oil heated up in this pan. I've just put some rice, 180 grams of rice, so that's 90 grams per person. This is brown rice, it takes about 20 minutes, so get that on nice and early. I've just put some water in there, that's all I've done so far, so I'll just set the timer for that. So all I'm going to do here is skin side down. You don't want the flame too high on there, you don't want the heat too high under here, because yes, you are going to burn it, that you can't really help but burn this stuff. That's part of the process that you actually want in. You don't want it to be too great. So just keep your rest of the teriyaki sauce that's been marinating to one side. So that'll rub back into your pan a little bit later on. In the meantime, on this side, I'm just prepping the onion and the peppers. Nothing flash, nothing that you've not seen before. Turn the rice down, not need to be going crazy. That's too smoky, that really, so I'm going to put that onto a different top, different lead. Just burn it back. Put it back onto the heat now, it's cooled down a little bit. You'll see it's quite black, but that's the teriyaki does that, that's quite normal. You can make your own teriyaki sauce, not something I've done myself, so maybe give it a try one day. This is a quick, easy way of doing it. You can see there, even though the heat's turned quite well down, that's still turning quite black. Put some mushrooms in as well, just to add to the veggie side of it. It's just a half a plate that was left from the other day. It's very noisy, isn't it? Try and get a bit of colour on the room this side. It's never easy to salmon because of the curve on the fish. Let's transfer those. I'm going to transfer those to the oven just to keep warm. A little bit more oil in there. Just for your veggies. Not much. Turn your heat up a little bit. So you want some of that burnt teriyaki sort of burnt, not burnt, but you know, teriyaki flavour going onto your veggies. With the mushrooms. And then you need to make sure this sauce cooks through because it's obviously been with raw fish. A little bit of sauce left in there, so I'll try and get that out as well.
You see how the teriyaki is starting to cut everything through now. It's starting to bubble through and sort of become more of a glaze than a sauce. That's what you want. You don't want too much of the teriyaki sauce. You don't want it to be too liquid.
Smells delicious.
You're going to get a little bit of, obviously your mushrooms are dead, I mean, they're 90% water anyway, so you're going to get some of the water from the mushrooms coming into the sauce, into the glaze. And also you've got quite a bit of water in with your peppers as well. So you need them to start cooked through, but you don't want them stewed. I'm going to turn that up a little bit more. Okay, let's turn it back down again. It's worth noticing that people cook rice in lots of different ways as well. I don't think it works with brown rice, but certainly with white rice. If you put, for every cup of white rice that you put, if you put 2 cups of water, and cook until, boil it until it starts to come to the boil, and then turn it off. Once all the water's evaporated, that's actually your rice should be cooked perfectly. Now that's the theory, and I don't know what it is. I can do it. I have done it. But I prefer to put more water in, and then at the end, run boiling water over it, and that to me leaves your rice a little bit fluffier. Like I say, horses for courses, really. That's how I like it. But brown rice is different. I don't think that theory works with brown rice. It's on the boil for too long. A little bit of taste in case it needs anything, salt and pepper wise. That'll be nicely. Behind you at the moment, I'm just doing some spring onions for decoration over the top. Does it bring anything to it?
Mm.
Actually, I think it does. that's perfect. I'm going to turn that off now because they're cooked through. You're actually starting to get, I'll show you under there, look. The actual liquid's just about all gone and it's starting to caramelise on the bottom. That's perfect. And to me, what I'm going to do is drain the rice off and then I'm going to just give it a couple of seconds so it's drained off fully, and then I'm going to put the rice into there, because what I don't want is if I serve rice and then the vegetables and then the salmon on top, which is probably how most people would do it, you're wasting loads of this lovely stuff in the bottom of this pan. So if I put the rice into there and then serve from there into my bowl, then that to me is you're getting everything that you can. Boil this water just to run over this rice to get rid of the starch a little bit. So that's your rice into your pan. You see how that rice is now taking up that what's left of the teriyaki, and like I say, it's more of a caramelisation now in the bottom of there. Might look a bit messy, but you know, I think it's all about the taste. Just turn you around so you can see. Get the salmon. So your salmon on the top. And that's it. Teriyaki salmon.